right, welcome to day two of the Loucin guitar project. I'm Bill, and today we forgot our tripod. That's why Garren is holding the camera. Sorry, Garren. So last week we bent this top. Actually, we cut it. This is not a top. This is the side. We cut the sides. I sanded them, and then we bent this one. Today we're going to bend the other side. Apparently, I'm going to be doing the bending today. So hopefully, it'll turn out as good as this one. And then we glued. If you remember, we glued the back. So that's all done and glued. Well, I'm going to sand that today, and actually probably going to cut it first and then sand it. And then we're going to glue the top, and that'll probably be it for today. So we're going to get right to it. Here we go.
All right, so we are, we're going to draw out the shape on the back piece.
Yeah, we're just going to center it on the backboard there, on the back of the guitar, on the center line and on the center line. Just to give us an idea where to cut it. And we're gonna cut it oversized. And there you go, right there.
That's it. So here's a couple guitars back there. You just told me about these ones. These are, they're sealed.
Yeah, they've got a sealer coat on, first coat of sealer coat.
Yeah.
After that, we sand it down, put a second coat of sealer, sand that down, and then we start the lacquering process,
yeah,
12
these,
coats.
These are pretty nice.
Yeah.
Especially this one. That's awesome. What's that wood again?
Zirconi.
That's cool.
Yeah.
So here you're just taking off the excess glue.
Yeah, just taking off the glue line because the glue dries rock hard and it's not very friendly on the sanding belts there.
Right.
So even as we're planing this, look at the beautiful color coming through.
Oh, I know, it's going to be awesome.
Yeah.
So let me get this straight. So we're getting, like so.
Yes.
All right, we're getting ready to do the bend, and since Garren's on the camera, he's going to you'll probably hear him talking a little bit as we go. So step one is, so here's the top here, it's labeled. And it's also the straight side. You can see the arch here. So it's going to go into the wax paper, and I'm going to try to line it up with line up the mark here with the mark there, so that they're basically right on the same spot, like so. And that's what I'm going to use after to line it up in the mold itself. So here we go. Yeah, I'm good to go.
Okay, so you're gonna want to get those gloves on right here.
Yeah. Yeah, right. Yeah. You should have just let me touch them.
Yeah, I should have.
Good for a blooper. All right, so get the gloves on because this thing is hot now. It's been heating up for 20 minutes or so now. All right, so step one, take this off. And this side off too.
You're looking like a pro.
Yeah, well, it's not done yet. All right, that's you. Undo the corkscrew. So if you remember from last time, this is gonna go in this way and I have to line it up and get it all straight, and then we're gonna bring the corkscrew down. And then after that, we're going to start bending. Okay, so here we go. So, like so. Hold on a second. Get that straight.
Just hang on to the top metal there, that's it, and just shoot it right in.
Right.
There you go.
Okay. So, whoop, don't drop that. So I'm trying to line this up like so. And got to get that in there a little bit more lined up like so. So, let's see if I...
Can you see the mark yet? I think you need to go in a bit further.
Yeah, I'm right there.
Okay.
So, but I also want these lined up as parallel as possible, right?
Correct.
So, like so. Okay. So, again, I want to get in there. So, I don't know if you can see that, but I've got the line on there, right on the line on the...
Okay.
Okay, am I good to go?
You're good to go.
All right, so I'm going to bring this down slowly. And
bring it down. Well, you can bring it down fast until it makes contact.
Oh, right, okay.
And then once you've made contact...
Right, then we're going to go...
Go a little slower and then just double check.
Right, and we're just going to keep
trying to make sure that this is lined up.
Okay, looks good.
So, all right.
And I want to keep this as straight as possible.
Yep.
Okay.
Parallel to the front edge there?
Yeah. So I think I'm good.
Go a little slower.
Just one more little check. See how I'm doing. All right, I think I'm still good. And I think this, I just have to eyeball this, right?
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I'm just
good. Okay. Okay, I'm still good.
Yeah, go until there's about a 16th of an inch between them.
Okay.
Well, that's good. Now pop the... Okay.
Now I'm doing this side.
Yeah. Throw this guy on.
All right.
I think it goes the other way. Spin it. 180. Right. There you go.
Thanks.
We were talking about some of the guys I've built for. We left out Jason Hook from Five Finger Death Punch last week.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
Okay, so here I go.
Just nice and consistent, even pressure all the way back. There you go. And just to the bottom of the mold. That's it.
All right.
That's it.
Oh, yeah. Oh shit. That's too far.
Okay, so push down on there. You can edit that part. There you go.
There we go.
Okay,
perfect. Leave that in. All right. Now this.
Okay, so this same
one.
Thing.
So it's sort of like that, right?
No. Yeah, the word up.
Oh, okay. Right.
Okay, I'm gonna come over here.
All right. Okay, so
I want to just make sure that stays in the flat.
So this is straight back.
Yeah. Nice right. And slow, and don't go too far.
Right.
There you go. That's right. It.
That's it.
Now the corkscrew. Give it one last final. That's it. Is it nice? It's fairly snug.
Yeah. It's. Yeah.
Okay. Perfect.
Okay.
Well, if the whole music store thing doesn't work out for you.
And that's it. So that's.
That's it. Now you can turn the heater back on to 20 minutes.
All right. All right.
We're good to go.
I've been my first side ever.
Good for you.
All right.
Awesome.
So we're back and we're picking our top now, and we decided, although in consultation on this set of Engelmann spruce,
yep.
Which is beautiful, and it's going to be I think it's going to be great. Very blonde looking, will be light and bright sounding, so it should be a great compliment. And now we are just Garren just told me something about the grain, so go ahead, yeah. Garren, tell us about this.
As you get to the center of the tree, the grain gets tighter. So what we have here is the tight grain going out to wider grain. So when we glue these together, we always put the tight grain in the center because we want the stiffness to be through the center. It's where your bridge is going to be attached.
Right. Right.
So you want a fairly stiff center. So we're just going to figure where we want. We like these like that. I'm just going to mark them so we can joint them and get them ready to glue.
All right, here I go. Very first top. So that piece there, this piece here, and together. Give them a little. Make sure we get that glue spread out. And all right, there we go. Now, Garren makes this look easy. We'll see if it really is. All right, so first one. Ha ha. Moved it already. All right. Little knot down here, and another one for safekeeping. All right.
Beautiful.
All right, now.
Let's wipe off the excess. Yeah.
All right, so we get the glue off. So technically, if this top ever cracked, they should come see me.
They should come and see you, yeah.
not you. All right. I don't think it's ever going to, though. But I feel like I've done an okay job. All right. So now the wedges are next. So this one through here and then through there.
You got it.
All right. Like so. All right. And this one like so. Simple yet so effective. All right, so that one like so. That's it.
You got it.
That's it.
Top's been roped and wedged and
joined.
Yeah.
All right, cool.